We began our serious research back in 1979, and that was prompted by this icon right here. One of my colleagues was doing research at St. Catherine's Monastery, Mount Sinai. It was researching their ancient manuscripts, but the St. Catherine's is the repository for a large number of early icons. The monk showed my friend this icon, which is a prize icon called Christ Pantocrator. And it was so striking, my friend asked the monk where that came from. The monk said, well, it's painted from the Shroud of Turin. Well, that immediately intrigued us because this icon was painted about 550 A.D. So that began our serious research, trying to find out whether the monk's story was correct or not. So we began looking to see how you might do accurate image comparison. What we finally wound up to be able to do is to take an image. This is actually a coin, a Byzantine coin, the first one with a depiction of Jesus on it. This coin was struck in 692. And we do an overlay comparison where we project, say, this image directly on top of the shroud image through polarizing filters so that we can shift back and forth and do accurate comparison to determine what we call points of congruence or similar features between these two. This is just an intermediate stage of this. And we can actually tabulate or count the points of congruence here so we can determine the statistical probability of the relationship between the two images. And we found that this image is highly related to the shroud image, although this image is less than an inch high on the coin. And so that we found that that is congruent. And the original image, the Pantocrator image, which we studied later on, has over 250 points of congruence between that and the shroud. And a court of law takes only 45 to 60 points of congruence to determine the same face. So we feel we have overwhelming evidence that the iconographer was looking directly at the shroud image in order to produce his image.